Hello students, today we are going to study different methods of soil stabilization. The methods of soil stabilization which are in common use are, the first one is mechanical soil stabilization, the next one is soil cement stabilization, the third one is soil lime stabilization, and last but not the least, that is soil bitumen stabilization. Now we will discuss one by one each and every method of soil stabilization, starting with the mechanical soil stabilization. Correctly proportioned materials, that is aggregate and soils, when adequately compacted to get a mechanically stable layer, the method is called as mechanical stabilization. It means that whenever we get adequately compacted stable layer, then the phenomena is called mechanical stabilization. Thus, the two basic principles in this method of stabilizations are, the first one is proportioning and the second one is compaction. If a granular soil containing negligible fines is mixed with a certain proportion of fine or binder soil, it is possible to increase the stability. Similarly, the stability of fine-grained soil could be considerably improved by mixing a suitable proportion of granular material to get a suitable gradation. It means that whenever we mix finer particle and granular material, we will get a suitable proportion of complete mixture, and that mixture will be of proper gradation, so the stability of that mixture will be very high. That's why if we want to increase the bearing capacity of the soil, or if we want to do the soil stabilization, then with the granular soil we have to mix certain amount of fine materials, or with the finer particles we have to mix certain amount of granular material to get a suitable gradation. The principle of mechanical soil stabilization has been successfully applied in the construction of sub-base and base courses of low volume roads. It means that we will apply the principle of mechanical soil stabilization only in sub-base course as well as for base courses also. This method has also been used as surface course for low cost roads such as village roads when the traffic and rainfalls are low. That is the mechanical soil stabilization. Now we will move towards the next type of stabilization, that is soil cement stabilization. Soil cement is an intimate mix of soil, cement and water, which is well compacted and cured to form a strong base course so as to fulfill the specified stability and durability. The term cement treated soil and cement modified soil refer to the compacted mixes when cement is used in small proportion to impart some strength or to modify the property of the soil, and these mixes do not fulfill the mix design requirement specified for soil cement. So, if we will mix the cement in water, or we can say that if we will mix the small proportion of cement in soil with water, then we will definitely increase the bearing capacity of that soil. In granular soil, the mechanism of stabilization is due to the development of bond between the hydrated cement and the compacted soil particles at the point of contact. It means that in case of granular soil, the mechanism of stabilization is due to the development of bond between the hydrated cement and the compacted soil particles at the point of contact. In fine-grained soil, the stabilization is due to reduction in plasticity and formation of matrix enclosing small clay lumps. It means that in case of finer grained soil, the stabilization is due to reduction in plasticity and formation of matrix. Degree of stabilization depends on nature of soil, proportion of cement. We will write it one by one. Degree of stabilization depends on nature of soil, proportion of cement, efficiency of mixing, compacting moisture content, and the dry density of the compacted mix. By the increasing percentage of cement added, there is an increase in the strength and durability of soil cement and a decrease in volume change, moisture movement, and plasticity of the fine grained soil. So, we had discussed the two techniques of soil stabilization. Now, we will move towards the next technique, that is soil lime stabilization. Soil lime stabilization. When soils are treated with lime, either modification in soil properties or binding or both action may take place. It means that when we add lime in the soil, then modification in the properties of soil will take place or binding action will take place or the combined action of both modification and binding will take place. In the case of clay soils with high plasticity, the predominant action is generally modification, resulting benefits such as reduction in plasticity and volume changes due to variation in moisture content. It means that in case of clay soil, due to the modification of soil properties, benefits such as reduction in plasticity, volume changes, etc. will take place. Other benefits are soil lime mixes become friable and easy to be pulverized, having less affinity with water. Also, there could be pozzolanic action resulting in slow rate of increase in strength with curing period. All these modifications are considered desirable in construction of soil stabilized road. Lime also imparts a little binding action in soil. It means that when we add lime, it will impart little binding action in the soil. The maximum dry density of soil lime mix is decreased by 2-3% in terms of untreated soil. It means that when we add the lime in the soil, then maximum dry density will decreased by 2-3% as compared to the untreated soils. However, this decrease in dry density with the addition of a small proportion of lime does not cause reduction in strength. It means that it will increase the bearing capacity of the soil, but it will not affect the other properties also in the negative manner. When a clay is treated with lime, the various possible reactions are base exchange reaction, coagulation or flocculation, reduction in thickness of water film around clay particles, cementing action, and carbonation will take place. The fine clay particles react with lime and get flocculated or aggregated into large particle groups, which are fairly stable even under subsequent soaking. Plastic clay soils tend to agglomerate more than silty and sandy soils. Due to this flocculation, the lime treated clays indicate a different grain size distribution, indicating substantial reduction in the proportion of fines. It means that when we mix the lime in the soil, then the proportion of fines will get reduced and we will get coarse grained particles of the soil. The changes in plasticity characteristic of soil lime mixture also takes place simultaneously. The total time required for the changes depends on several factors, including the soil type. That is the third technique of soil stabilization, that is soil lime stabilization. Now we will proceed towards the next type of stabilization, that is soil bitumen stabilization. The basic principle of bituminous stabilization is considered as waterproofing with some binding action. By waterproofing, the inherent strength and other properties of the soil could be retained. In case of the cohesionless soil, the binding action is also important. Generally, both binding and waterproofing actions are provided to soil. In granular soils, the coarse grains may be individually coated and stuck together by a thin film of bituminous material. But in fine grained soil, bituminous material plugs up the voids between small soil clots, thus waterproofing the compacted soil bitumen. Most commonly used bitumen or bituminous materials are cutback bitumen and emulsion. As heating of large quantity of soil and bitumen is not possible, a suitable grade of cutback is chosen depending upon the climatic condition and mixing problem in order to enable mixing at day temperature of the locality. Emulsions also may be used, especially in places when there is scarcity of water for construction purposes. It means that generally we will use the cutback bitumen, but where the water scarcity problem is there, then we will use the emulsion. After the soil bitumen is compacted, the layer is cured, and during the curing period, the water and volatiles evaporate and mix hardens, which will ultimately increases the bearing capacity of the soil. Bituminous stabilized layer may be used as a sub-base or base course of low volume roads and even as surface course for roads with light vehicle in low rainfall regions. So students, we had completed all the methods of soil stabilization. Thank you very much, students.